I'll stitch this together and make another one, just putting the bits and pieces back on, getting rid of the slime in the case. I'll save that gasket so I'll just use a bit of silicone on it. Everything's good. I might as well check the push rod gap while I'm in here, might as well. Right. Put that piece of shit down there. What you have?
Nine sixteen, so is that one. Right, I'll just back my cable off on the fire adjuster. Right, got plenty of slack in there. I'm gonna clog that off. I'm just going to wind that in till it touches. Yeah, it's just touched there, so I've got a couple of turns. Yeah, just lifting the plate. Slack. Can we see the position? I'm just going to do it about a quarter off. Yeah. See that? Yeah, that's touching. I'm going to do it to about there. Pull the slack up on the cable. Lovely, that's the clutch push rod. You put the clears on now. Bit of silicone around it. Right, I think we've all zoomed up a little bit there. Not to worry. Anyway, I've just filled this up with the silicone where the wires go through. A little bit in the back, so probably that'd be nice and airtight. Right, emulsified oil. See some of the crap in here. And that's what's left of that encapsulation off that bloody alternator. Yes. Yeah, let's give it a bit of a clean out. Yeah, this is emulsified oil. It's what happens when water vapor gets mixed up with oil vapor. It's fairly normal. The longer your rides, I do fairly long rides, like, so I'm surprised at seeing this. Well, it's just a case of get it out. Let's see. Oh. Right, a bit of silicone. Clog my finger, just a little tiny bit around the edge. Just enough. It doesn't want to be beading, it doesn't want to be out ridiculous. Right, a bit of silicone around there. Won't clag it on. Right. Oh, I need the exhaust off, I think. To get them bottom bolts in. Whip the exhaust off again. Oops. Right. There's four longish ones on mine, and then a couple of slightly shorter. The short ones I go put in these two, the rest are all the same size. Primary chain, we'll just think that's all right. It had, well, I don't know, 3/4 of an inch slack. So that'll do, it's not bad. I'd rather run with a chain a bit slack than too tight. And then nip every other one, the lighter ones up. So that's all the smaller ones nipped. great. Copper washer, ordinary washer. I have to get some dome nuts for these. Copper. And I'll do over that. Far too much enough on there. Bit on the edge. A bit monkey with that silicon on there. Plug in. Yeah. Good radius that to fit them. Could do with the edges sawn off. I think that's about it on there. Might give that a bit of a. I'm not going all take say I want to ride the bugger. joint, it'll do for that, front pipe on. Oh, what a dibber. I put the footrest on. Ah! Oh, but I have to take the front off again. A bastard, I do. What a tit. Oh, dear. Oh, practice makes perfect. Nice footrest. Disconnect the brake. Footrest has pins on, and the pins go in the holes. Concave on the back. And then the open ender in a fashion. I keep promising to grind my footrest one day. Give it a wiggle, make sure it's in the pins. I see that's going to tighten without turning that. Just an extra spring there, I hook around me pedal. Adjust up me back brake. And that'll do for that. Lock nut up. Put my vipes on again. don't know how much of that you saw. Nip up there, Jack. Nip up your silencer clamp. Again, they don't have to be too tight, these. You can tighten them till it distorts the bracket, but waste of time, really. And a 9/16 just to nip that up. Pipes on, case on. The only thing I haven't done is put a drop of oil in the primary. It will top up itself. Well, I think that's it. Done.